Rajnish Dubey, and today I am here along with a new lesson of class 11th from Snapshot Book. The name of this lesson is The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. This lesson is written by William Saroyan. So students, this video is going to be very helpful for class 11th students, because in this video I am going to cover most very important topics like as about the author and theme of this lesson and paragraph wise explanation, after all suggested question answers, all the things. So this is very important, and I am given its summary in the description list. So be continue with me and watch this video till to.
Oh God, one more remix.
Four main protagonist characters. First one, Aram. Aram was 9 years old boy. And second one character is Aram's cousin brother Murad. And third one character is Uncle Khusro. Actually, Uncle Khusro was a very good person. He always said that for any kind of matter, if any matter held, then he said that don't pay attention on it. We have no need to talk about this. It's no harm. Don't pay attention on it. Then the fourth main, very most character is John Byrow. John Byrow was a farmer. So students, just write down all the characters and about itself. It is mentioned in this video. So my dear learners, I am going to explain this story. Actually, this story revolves around two poor Armenian boys, Murad and Aram. They are members of the Rogalian family, and their tribe is very famous for their trust and honesty. This is the morning time when story begins. Aram was 9 years old boy and his cousin Murad was 13 years old. Then Aram remembers vividly that day when Murad came to his house at 4 in the morning and woke up him by tapping the windows of his room. After listening such kind of voice, Aram jumped out of the bed, and when he looked out of the window, then he couldn't believe what he saw. His cousin Murad was sitting on a beautiful white horse. And Murad asked him to be quick out if he wanted to ride. After listening this, Aram said that, "Yes, I want to ride on this beautiful white horse. Just wait for a minute. Just wait." Aram has the sense about this. His whole Garugalian family was poor, though well known for their trust and honesty. Then Aram knew that his cousin Murad couldn't have bought this horse. And if he couldn't have bought it, then he must have stolen it. But Aram refused to believe he had stolen it, because no member of Garugalian family could be a thief. But he asked this question to his cousin Murad, where he had stolen that horse. Then Murad did not reply, but asked him to keep out of the window if he wanted to ride. He knew that Murad was crazy regarding horses. Stealing a horse for a ride was not the same as the thing of stealing of money and selling up anything or stolen horses. That means, according to his opinion, Aram is saying here, for completing his wishes. If his cousin Murad had bought this horse, then this is not
Aram to walk up
into his clothes. He jumped down to the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind his cousin Murad. From their house in Walnut Avenue, they reached Olive Avenue in less than 3 minutes. The horse began to trot. As the air was fresh and lovely to breathe, and on that time, Murad was considered one of the craziest members of Aram's family. On the way, he began to sing in a roaring manner. They reached the open country and let the horse run as long as it felt like running. That means you can see from the house of Aram's to open field, they covered this distance within 3 minutes. And on the way, Murad was singing a song in a roaring manner because he was so curious to ride this such kind of beautiful white horse. Murad said to Aram to get down as he wanted to ride alone. Then Aram asked him if he would let him ride alone, then he will get down from this horse. Then Murad replied that, yes, I will give you this chance if you are able. Then Aram got down and his cousin Murad kicked his heels into the horse and shouted, Wazire, run! After listening this kind of voice, that horse stood on its hind legs, snorted, and ran forward at a fast speed. Then Murad reached the horse across a field of dry grass to an irrigation ditch. He crossed the ditch on the horse, and 5 minutes later he returned back, and on that time he was dripping.
The sun was coming up.
Now the turn of Aram's came. Then Aram leaped to the back of the horse, but the horse did not move because Aram had no sense how to move the horse. At the suggestion of Murad, he kicked into the muscles of the horse. Then the horse reared and snorted and began to run. Then Aram did not know what to do when horse is running. Instead of running across the field of the irrigation ditch, the horse ran down the road of the vineyards of Dikran and leaped over 7 vines before Aram fell. After failing Aram, Murad came running down the road. He was more worried about the horse than Aram. Both of them searched the horse in different directions. It took near about half an hour to find the horse again. Then Murad hid the horse in the deserted vineyard belonging to Farmer Fadwijan. There were some oats and dry alfalfa in the barn. It occurred to Aram that Murad had been taking early rides for some time and not informing him. He's riding this horse from earlier before some days, never inform him, and had came him that morning only. So for this he inquired. He asked this question to his cousin Murad. Hey bhai, how long ago did you steal this horse?
Aram added the same very question again. How long did you begin riding every morning?
Then Murad replied, not until this morning. After listening this answer, Aram knows well his cousin Murad was not speaking the truth, but he convinced him by saying so. Then Murad told to Aram, if you want to ride the horse in a well manner, so nicely, then you have need to know the rules and regulations to ride the horse. Then Aram reached home, and at his home he ate a hearty breakfast, very delicious breakfast. Then on same very day, that afternoon, his uncle Khusro, just mind it uncle about Uncle Khusro always said, for any kind of matter,
it's no harm, don't pay attention on it. So that Uncle Khusrow came to the Aram's house for coffee and cigarette, for coffee and cigarettes. While Uncle was sipping coffee and smoking in the parlor, then another visitor came. Just be minded, who is the another visitor? Another visitor was the horse real owner, John Byrow. Then the latter was a farmer. John Byrow came. He was an Armenian who had learned to speak Armenian. He said here, then Uncle Khusrow served him same as the coffee and tobacco. Then on same time, John Byrow was looking so sad. He said to the Khusrow about his trailing horse. He said that his horse had been stolen by someone. Then Uncle Khusrow cried a lot, don't pay attention on it, it's no harm. Then he said, my legs are paining for coming here. Then Uncle Khusrow again replied, hey man, at least you have legs, so you have no need to worry, about this. It's no harm. Don't pay attention. He had to walk 10 miles to reach there, and his left leg pained him. The horse had cost him $60, and his story was not too good. Without a horse, that means he is not able to do his work without horse. So as soon as farmer went away, Aram ran over to cousin Murad's house and told him each and every matter. He disclosed each and every matter in front cousin Murad. He asked Murad not to return it till he learned to ride. Then Murad suggested that keeping it for a year for you. That means you are saying, I will keep it for 1 year. Keeping it for 1 year for you, at least 6 months. This is not possible. Murad thought he was inviting a Garvelian family to steal. He decided to return the horse to its true owner. Early morning, for a few weeks, Murad and Aram took the horse out of the barn and deserted vineyards where they were hiding it and rode it. Every morning, the horse would leap over grapes, vines and small trees and throw Aram and ran away. Means always the horse just threw the Aram from his back and ran away. Still Aram hoped to learn to ride as Murad's rode. Then one morning on the way to Fat Vision's desert vineyards, they came across then John Byrow meet him on the way. After looking John Byrow, Murad greeted him. Then John Byrow studied the horse eagerly and wished him good morning, my dear. When Murad greeted him, then farmer John Byrow studied the horse eagerly and wished him good morning. He asked the name of their horse. Then Murad replied that its name is My Hurt. He said that my horse name is My Hurt. Then John Byrow called, it is a very lovely name for such kind of lovely horse. He was certain that it was the horse which had been stolen from him many weeks ago. He sure that this is his horse. But he asked if he might look into the horse's mouth. He wants to assure it. So for this, he wants to look the horse teeth. So on examining the teeth of the horse, the farmer was ready to swear that it was his own horse. But since the fame of their family or their tribe, they all are famous for their honesty and trust, he knows well. So for this, he's not saying this is his horse. He said that this horse is a twin of my horse. That means in this way, John Byrow hides such kind of stealing. Then the next same day. Aram and Murad both returned this horse to Jan Bairo's house. Then same very afternoon, Jan Bairo came with his beautiful white horse and said to the uncle Khusro, "Thank God, I have got my this horse. So thank you very much to the God." After listening this, Uncle Khusro cried a lot. He said that you have got your horse, na? So you have no need to just be discussed in front.
In this way, you have a lot of sense about the Armenian and its tribe. This is the story of mainly two boys, Aram and Murad, and how Aram is going to complete his wish to ride the horse. And about the Jan Bairo, when Jan Bairo came to meet Mr. Khusro, and as reply, Mr. Khusro said that it's no harm, don't pay attention on it. So you have no need to worry about this. And finally, Jan Bairo has the sense, he has the sense about that horse is his horse. But finally, he is not disclosed this matter in front of those boys, Aram and Murad, because he has the information about this. Now, Armenian tribe is very famous for their trust and honesty. So he doesn't want to do this work for such kind of mistake. So finally, Aram and Murad just returned back this horse to Jan Bairo. And this way, the whole story will be going on and completed. So maybe students, according to my opinion, this video is very helpful for you all. So just pen down all the things, because in this video, I am given all CBSE boards related question and its answers and all the things. And don't forget to like it, like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you. Thank you very much. And just proceed, we write down the question answer.